Hello and welcome back to In the Kitchen with Matt. I am your host, Matt Taylor. Today, I'm going to show you how to make a strawberry sauce or compote that you can put on pancakes, waffles, crepe, whatever you like to do, cheesecake. Oh yeah, cheesecake. But before we go on, make sure to hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you'll know anytime that I post a new video. This is really easy to make, simple ingredients. If I can do it, you can do it. Let's get started. All right, to begin, we need a sauce pot and some kind of spoon. I'm using my marbled silicone spoon that I got from Culinary Edge. This thing is awesome. I love the look of it. It's just super sturdy and it just really neat, looks really cool. Now we have 1 cup of strawberries. I washed them and then cut the tops off of them. And now we want to cut them up in quarters and put them in our pot. And you could use a knife to do that. You can just cut these on the cutting board first before. I just wanted to show you what they look like whole first. Okay, so just go ahead and put them in there. Again, so this is 1 pound of strawberries that I sliced, and you could easily switch that out with peaches or blackberries or blueberries, you know, whatever kind of fruit that you want to do. Now let's add 1 cup of white granulated sugar. And then let's add 2 tablespoons of lemon juice or orange juice, whatever you want to do. I also have 1 teaspoon of cornstarch and about 2 tablespoons of water, but we're going to use this a little bit later. Let's take this over to the stovetop. All right, here we go. We have the pot on the stovetop and we have the burner set just below medium heat, somewhere between medium low and medium. And then what we're going to do is with our spoon, we're going to come in here and just, we're going to periodically stir this. And we're going to let this fruit cook down. The sugar is going to dissolve. And this whole process will take about 5 to 10 minutes. Once again, I really like my marbled silicone spoon. I'll put a link down below in the description where you can buy it. Again, it's by Culinary Edge. Love this thing. I also love how sturdy this spoon is, and I like that it's not gonna scratch up my pot here. And I could totally just throw this in the dishwasher safe. And it's also heat resistant up to 450 degrees Fahrenheit. Pretty awesome. So just keep stirring those strawberries and you're gonna watch as the sugar dissolves. And we just wanna cook up these strawberries a little bit. All right, at this point, it's getting to the point where it's bubbling. You see the little bubbles and it's very runny. So we want to thicken this up a little bit. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our water, our 2 tablespoons of water over here. And we're just gonna add in our cornstarch. Just go ahead and add that to the mixture. And that's gonna help thicken it up a little bit. All right. So after a few more minutes with it in the with the cornstarch in there, you can see it's getting more thick. And now this is pretty much ready to go. And you can serve it just like this. Serve it warm, let it cool down a little bit, and serve it warm over your pancakes or your waffles or with ice cream or something, just like this with the chunks if you want. Or let's go ahead and put this in for a nice smooth texture. Let's go ahead and put this in the blender. All right, I'm over here at my blender. Let's just go ahead and drop this in there. Watch out for the splatter. Nice.
All right, and that's how you make a strawberry sauce or compote. Super easy to do. If you want a recipe for crepes, this sauce goes great with that. Check out this recipe over here. If you want a recipe for waffles, down here you can check out an awesome recipe for waffles. And of course, subscribe there in the corner and hit that notification bell. I'm Matt Taylor with In the Kitchen with Matt. Take care. Time for me to dive into this. Oh yeah.